Someone asked for my opinion or do a video about John Fetterman. Hey, John Fetterman's a great guy. I wish I could have voted for him, but I'm not in Pennsylvania. And I hope he beats the crap out of Oz. Oz is a carpetbagger, man. Why would you vote for somebody that doesn't live in your state? Plus, he's an asshole. Hey, there's two other senators that have had strokes, and they're in the Senate right now working. John is getting better every day. He's a really good guy. He was a great attorney general, and he'll be a great senator. He was every part of his career, he's been really good at it, and he cares about people. That's the most important thing. And like I said, I wish I could vote for him, man. I really wish. And this shouldn't have any way of stopping him from being a good senator. And I hope he does a great job. I hope they get him elected, because it's important. By the way, my friends in Pennsylvania, you can't vote for that fascist pig, Mastriano, man. I mean, he's crazy. He's a fascist, Nazi, white supremacist, wannabe Christian, nationalist. He's crazy, man. I mean, I just can't believe they put him on the ticket. I really can't. You know, my uncles, they went to World War, when they were in World War II, they made it a point. They actually told me, they said, you know, we made it a point. Every time we saw an SS, we shot him in the head, because the SS helped Hitler start World War II. And they were the assholes that ran the concentration camps and the slave labor camps. And we made sure they got killed. Every last one of them we could find. And actually, one of my uncles said, hey, after Fury came out, he said, man, that's what we did. He said, man, that's what we did. He said, man, we made sure of killing those damn SS. Mastriano's an SS Nazi, man. That's what you are, son. You're a fucking Nazi. And you don't deserve to be governor of the great state of Pennsylvania, man. Stinky bastard. That's just my opinion. But I don't like, personally, I don't like white supremacists, neo-Nazis, Christian nationalists, Ku Klux Klan, you name it. Do you not like it? And QAnon is right up there too, because they're taking the playbook out of the anti-Semitic handbook. All they talk about, they've just turned it a little bit different. It's the same stuff that they would be talking about us Jews. Plain and simple, man. The difference is, you come for me, you ain't going to get me. I'm too well armed, and I know how to use it. That's my right-leaning side. I believe in the Second Amendment, but it's gone too far on a lot of things. People are abusing the Second Amendment too badly. We need tougher. It has to be tougher to get a gun in this country. You need to go through better checks. And we need to deal with mental health. For some reason, our mental health system is letting us down. There's too many people that have too many problems that when they get a firearm, they just want to go out and kill as many people as possible. And that's not right. It isn't. Now, I'm a long, long time gun owner. My first firearm I got at 7 years old. And I was taught that responsibility. It's my responsibility. You don't aim it at somebody else. You know, everything is your responsibility and it got to be taken 100%. You can't fuck around with this stuff. People's lives are at risk when you fuck around with firearms. Friend of mine, great kid, man. Smart, worked for IBM. Came back from hunting. For some reason, I don't know why, he didn't do it. He didn't cycle through his weapon. He accidentally killed himself cleaning his rifle. When I heard that, I nearly went, fucking what the fuck? That's the first thing you do before you even go to the car. You double check your weapon, make sure it's empty. I was taught before, even if it's a pop pistol, you know it's a non-operating pistol or rifle, it's not even a weapon. You treat everything that looks like a gun, it's a gun until proven otherwise. And until it's shown that it's empty, you treat it as a loaded firearm. And when I hear about people accidentally kill themselves because it was loaded, whoa. You need some schooling. But I don't want to go any farther on that. I just want to say, John Fetterman, you're my type of person. I have nothing against you that you had your stroke, and I hope you're a great senator because you're always been a good person. Bye-bye.